construction starts. Just that easy.
Mm-hmm.
Grinding off the subframe mounting bolts.
We're done.
Huh?
You gotta take those washers off.
That won't reach?
Yeah. They actually stop the tool from contacting the hole.
And then you can either sawzall or a grinder this flange off right here, flat, flush with the frame rail. Although, we may not need to. Let's jack it up and see. Watch that brake line, too, when you get up there.
Oh, yeah, I see it.
Do you have any thin cardboard there?
It's that easy.
Uh-huh.
We've spent a bunch of time getting the motor wiggled into place. We're pretty happy with where it is now as far as front to back, side to side. So we started out using these strings based on measurements we took from when the car still had its original rear end to get it pretty close. And then we started measuring off different mounting points on the motor and the car itself to get it centered up really good. And so now we've taped off, we're going to cut under this green line, and that should give us enough clearance to move the motor up to its final location. We're planning on moving the actual motor itself up just half an inch, and then we'll have an extra half inch for clearance since it sits on these rubber mounts and it'll move around a little bit. So we previously cut this side out, and then we took this piece of cardboard and made a template with marks for different bolts that are or were in there. Then we are going to use this to copy that same cut over to the other side, more or less. Doesn't have to be super exact, but pretty close. All right, so now we've cut this side out. Using our template, we more or less copied that over. So now we're going to get ready to do the center cross rail there. We've set up the laser level to produce a nice straight line on the bottom there, and then put some tape to mark where that is, and then we're going to angle grinder that out.